UMass is a really unique place and provides a really wide range of research opportunities for our med students, residents, fellows, and faculty. We have a world-class translational research program in neurodegenerative disease where we partner with faculty from the Gene Therapy Center and have been instrumental in helping develop novel gene therapies for Tay-Sachs and other neurodegenerative diseases.
I think the research environment here at UMass is really unique because it's very supportive and there's lots of resources for those people who want to do research.
Tay-Sachs disease is a disease, genetic disease, so inherited disease caused by mutations in one gene that leads to a deficiency in an enzyme that essentially clears up substances that accumulate in the brain. So you can imagine that a child that is affected with this disease, unfortunately, depending on the mutation, they actually never develop properly. And so this is why we've been involved in gene therapy, where the goal really is not to, you know, supply the missing enzyme to the cells, it's actually tell the cells how to make a normal copy of the protein. We know that if we put engineer cells in very specific locations in the brain, what happens to the enzyme is the enzyme gets distributed throughout the entire brain. We don't necessarily need to deliver genes to every cell in the brain. Fortunately enough, we have this mechanism that allow us to just engineer small parts of the brain and through the existing wiring, just get distributed throughout. And really that led us to be able to conduct the first in-human trial here at UMass in two patients.
So we did Tay-Sachs testing in animals. And what we found was as we went up into larger and larger animals, the distribution of the therapeutic wasn't very good. Especially to certain parts of the spinal cord and the back part of the brain called the cerebellum. And we wanted to try to find a way to address this. And one of the natural ways to do this is use cerebrospinal fluid, which is the cushioning fluid barrier that surrounds the brain and spinal cord. But traditionally, we haven't been able to do that because the human anatomy makes it very, very difficult to inject at the base of the head without risk.
We used interventional neuroradiological techniques, which involve really small soft tubes, essentially about the size of a spaghetti. And we were able to introduce that into the lumbar spine, but then navigate it using our imaging equipment to the base of the brain for delivery of the agents. It's really about bringing different departments and expertises together. We have a center that's an image-guided surgery center where we can use multiple imaging modalities that are clinical equipment. And we can use these in translational models so that when you're ready and you have efficacy and safety of a compound and a delivery strategy, it's very simple to translate that into the clinical environment, which enabled, as Miguel had said, you know, the treatment of two kids with Tay-Sachs.
Two of the strengths in our program are the aneurysm research and the stroke research. Both we are studying different devices in the aneurysm side. For example, we evaluate different types of coils, different thickness of coils, and see how they influence aneurysm occlusion. We also analyze the blood flow to the aneurysm when we use a device called flow diverter. On the stroke side, we analyze different devices, new devices that are still not in the market, or we analyze the post-market performance of devices that have been approved, but we also are trying to enroll patients in clinical research. So we are using cutting-edge technology compared to other places.
Breast cancer is a common public health problem. Mammograms are the best screening tool available to us today. But this tool is error-prone. We do have what is called a computer-aided detection. This is some form of an AI, but this has not served the test of time. So I was looking for some other robust AI tool that'll help us diagnose a cancer early. In a pilot study, we compared the reading capability of fellowship-trained breast images with an AI model that was provided to us by a local firm called DeepHealth. The AI model outperformed all expert readers, not only in the diagnosis of the index cases, but also in the pre-index examination. What we plan to achieve by this joint venture is the ability to detect cancers earlier, find more cancers, avoid unnecessary recalls and biopsies, reduce patient anxiety, and overall improve the health of women in the state of Massachusetts.
I love the institution of UMass Medical School to do research and to work at. It's such a supportive, friendly environment. I'm so fortunate to have a chair in a department that's very supportive, a medical school that is so supportive and has tons of resources at my fingertips. And it's just a great place to work. All the clinicians are friendly. Like, I've been at institutions where I've seen like issues between departments, and we just really don't have that here. Everyone really works together as a team.
We are in that perfect spot where we're not too big and we're not too small. We have a much larger research footprint than most departments our size. So it's really the perfect place to train as a resident or a fellow if you're interested in also doing basic science research, because we will find a way of getting you that opportunity.